Hey, what's up guys, and welcome to my beginner guide for Princess Connect Global. So the point of this guide is to essentially try and provide you with enough information to give you a good understanding of the game and how to start off on a good foot, and to hopefully answer any beginner questions you might have as a new player. We'll be covering pretty much everything the game has to offer, with an emphasis on the three main parts of the game, or at least what I consider the main parts of the game, which is your story mode, your PvP, and your clan battle. And then we'll just tie it up with whatever is kind of left. We'll be quickly looking into things like maybe your dailies, the guildhouse, the shop, all that kinds of stuff. So hopefully by the end of the video, you'll have a good idea of what it is you want to focus on, where it is you want to focus your resources and your time, and you'll have a good idea of where to focus your attention at the start of the game so you can get those juicy short-term benefits, and you'll have an idea of how to plan ahead for those long-term gains. So, with that being said, let's just get to it. Before we actually jump into the game, let's go ahead and answer some of the more common questions I see floating around. The first one being, is the game free-to-play friendly? Short answer to that, yes. The game is incredibly free-to-play friendly. You honestly don't even have to drop a dime in this game to become competitive. As long as you're willing, I would say, to put a little bit of research into what it is you want to do, and providing you kind of allocate your resources wisely. As long as you take advantage of, say for instance, the double drops that we have that are consistently throughout this game, and you know exactly where you want to allocate your resources into what characters, you don't have to spend a dime. You'd be fine. So that kind of answers that. The other question I see popping up a lot recently is actually, can I join now or have I kind of missed the window? If I join now, will I be forever playing catch-up? This is a little bit more of a complicated answer, but kind of hang with me here. You could join today and be fine, but it kind of depends on what you want to do, right? Like, if you are just looking for like a casual gacha game, or you're just looking to kind of have fun, you want to be a little bit competitive, but you're not like crazy into the competitive side, you don't want to join any like top 100, top 50 clans or anything like that, you could join today and you'd be totally fine. You'll probably see that there's a lot of emphasis on two characters, and specifically one that is a summer event which just passed. You'll kind of see a lot of information saying, oh my god, if you didn't get her and you're starting now, you're going to be screwed, you'll never be able to compete or anything like that. Honestly, I don't think that's true, simply because even if you were wanting to join today and become incredibly competitive later on, you're still looking at quite some time before you actually get to max level to actually compete. So what I mean by that is, and I would say roughly it takes about 6 to 7 months from level 1 to get all the way to max level. So my argument there is, okay, sure, you may have missed the Summer Carol character that just came in the summer event, who only comes during summer. If you start today, you're not even going to be max level until 6-7 months down the line, right? And then you're only a couple months out before she's released again. So you could join this game at any time, and honestly, I think you'd be fine. So that kind of covers that. With those questions out of the way, let's go ahead and dive into the game. All right, so to start things off, we're going to take a look into this quest tab right here. This is going to take us to what I consider the three main parts of the game. You've got your story mode, you've got your PvP, which is your battle arena and princess arena right here, and then you've got your clan battle. To start things off, let's go ahead and take a look at the story. Now, I'm not going to go into this too deep right now because honestly, it kind of speaks for itself and it's very straightforward. It's your typical progression, right? You've got all these different zones. You go through each level, you get better gear, you level up, same old, right? There are three things that I think are worth mentioning to a starting player, and that is these guys right here, which is the stars, as you can see. This is like a ranking system for that specific level. If you get 3 stars, that means none of your characters died. If you get 2 stars, that means 1 character died. And then if you get 1 star, that means 2 or more characters died. Now, I want to just put a little bit of emphasis on trying to get 3 stars, simply because it unlocks 2 things. You get a one-time reward of gear and jewels. Jewels are incredibly important for a new player because that is the resource you need in order to pull in the gacha system. So this is going to be of high demand for any new player. The other thing is it unlocks something called skip tickets. Skip tickets are another resource that you'll just kind of like passively come across. You'll get them from your grotto dailies, you'll get them from login bonuses, you'll get them from events, all kinds of stuff. You'll kind of just accumulate them. Think of them as kind of like just a time saver. Once you've three-starred a zone, say for instance you need to come back to that level and you're farming this specific piece of gear, you can use the skip tickets and you can instantly get the reward, meaning you don't have to actually just do the level over and over and over again. It's just a time saver, but it is handy later on down the line. So definitely try and three-star. Don't get too caught up on it if you are struggling with it and you would rather just push the story, totally okay. But if you happen to get like one or two, maybe three zones ahead, don't forget to go back and clear up those three stars just for the one-time rewards and being able to use skip tickets. The other thing I want to mention, and this is something that I think a lot of people overlook or actually don't even know about, is say for instance you're all the way up here and you get to 410 and you're just completely stuck and you don't know what to do. There's a little button right up here called past parties, and past parties actually means it's what other players used to complete that level and at what star level. So as you can see right here by clicking on it, I can see these are three different players who all three starred them and exactly what team composition they used. You can see what player level they were, you can see their total party power, you can see the individual stars. It just gives you all the information you need. You can even watch it if you want to. Super handy if you ever get stuck. You can come in here, you can copy it if you want, you can just kind of take a look and you can kind of get some ideas. Super handy if you ever get stuck. Don't underestimate past parties. Now the last thing I just want to quickly go over, and it's not too important for a new player, but it's the hard mode. And so basically you unlock hard mode for every time you complete a zone. So you complete zone one, you unlock hard mode for zone one, right? So the difference here is one, each of the levels in hard mode costs significantly more stamina. So it's not something I'd recommend for a new player. It's kind of something you do when you've gotten to a far enough point in the actual story to the gear doesn't matter so much. It's actually you want to start getting the star levels up. That's where you start going into hard mode. Like I said, it's just something to point out. If you get to zone three or something and you're like, you know what, I'm going to go try and unlock some of these hard modes, feel free. Try to three star them all the way as you can. You can only do them three times a day. You can obviously spend jewels to reset them. But for the most part, don't worry about them at the start. But as you get later into the game, this is where you're probably going to be spending almost all of your time and resources. So it's just something to quick mention. Let's go ahead and jump now into the PvP side of things, which kind of comes in two forms, very similar, is Battle Arena and Princess Arena. Let's start with the Battle Arena. Now, the Battle Arena is, it's more of like a ladder ranking system, right? So you start off at whatever level it is. I think it's like 15,000 or something like that. And you just climb the ladder. So you have a team of five that you would set up right here in your defense. This is the team that I put kind of like into the run of things. That's the team that other people would be facing off against. And then as you can see, these are the other guys at what ranks they are right now and their teams. Couple things to note on this is the general rule of thumb when it comes to arena, at least from what I've discovered, is it boils down to two things. Star rating, meaning the ascension level. As you can see, this guy right here has five stars in absolutely everybody. Five stars is kind of what you want to aim for all of your characters. Stars are generally always good in Battle Arena. Not necessarily in some of the other aspects of the game, but in Battle Arena, the more stars, the better. The other thing is it's heavily reliant on team composition. So for instance, you could be, as a new player, 10, maybe 12 levels lower than your opponent, but if you have a solid team, or if you have a team that directly counters them, chances are you'll still come out on top. Because that's just kind of how Arena works. It all comes down to team composition. So with those things being said, one thing I really want to stress, and I can't stress this enough for a new player, is this is where you're going to get all of your jewels at the start of the game. The amount of jewels you get from PvP in this game is just crazy. So I highly recommend, no matter what characters you started with, even if you were lucky and say you pulled some incredibly strong 3-star characters for clan battle, still come here and put a lot of attention into this. Even if you don't really like it or you don't really enjoy it or anything, at least come in here and try to use your 5 attempts a day down here. Because just pushing 20, 30 places can sometimes net you hundreds of jewels. It's really is a good resource for jewels for a beginning player. So don't overlook Arena. Once you've climbed as far as you can kind of put it a little bit on the back burner, because all of the jewels you earn in Arena is like kind of like a, it's like a one time only. So for instance, and this is where a lot of people get confused, is say I'm rank 300 and I climb to 250. And within those 50 ranks, I netted myself 700 jewels. Now I go to bed and I wake up the next day and I've been pushed back. I'm now rank 320. So I reclimb the ladder and I get back up to 260 or something like that. Because my best rank is 250, I won't gain any more jewels. You only gain jewels on your all-time like best rank that you've reached. That's something to remember, because yes, it's a great way to get a ton of jewels quickly if you can rank pretty fast, but it's only the one time. So once you've tend to hit rank 1 or like really high and you get stuck, you can kind of put it on the back burner. But that being said, any new player, definitely spend some time in the arena. You'll get a ton of jewels, which means you'll just be able to strengthen your roster early on. Same thing goes for the Princess Arena. I'm not going to dive into it too much. It works the exact same. You choose your team, you climb your ranks. The only difference is it's 3 teams rather than just the 1 team. So essentially, Princess Arena, I wouldn't touch it personally unless you have been playing for quite some time and you feel like you've actually got a decent roster, because this is more for later game, obviously, because you need at least 10 to 15 relatively geared characters to kind of compete. Definitely throw something in if you've unlocked it just to see where you can get. You might be able to net yourself some jewels, but for the most part, I wouldn't mess around with Princess Arena too much until quite later on. So now let's end off with the final part, and this is the clan battle. Now clan battle is, and I'm probably not going to dive into it too much, because if you spend 5 minutes, you'll find there's all kinds of information on clan battle, and by no means am I any kind of expert here, but clan battle is essentially, think of it as like a boss rush. So as you can see, we actually have one going on right now. My clan and I are basically progressing through each and every one of these bosses, and you get 3 attempts a day, which you'll unlock from just doing various things in the game, like farming gear and whatnot, progressing story. You'll unlock an attempt, you go in here, you use your team, you do as much damage as you can, and you work together as a clan to get the boss down. That's pretty much what clan battle is. It comes up at the end of every month, so it's like a monthly thing. It lasts for, I want to say, about a week. I think it's about 7 or 8 days, something like that. And it's just a boss rush. You try and kill as many bosses as you can. Once you've cleared all 5, you go into another lap. It's the same thing, it's just they're obviously harder. That's pretty much it. I'm not going to dive into it too deeply, because you can find information all over the place for clan battle. But that's pretty much it at a glance. And then obviously, depending on where you placed against other clans, that will determine the rewards you get. Obviously, you get kind of a decent amount of rewards for competing in clan battle. So this is kind of what I would almost consider the main part of the game. This is sort of the main attraction. But like I said, that's kind of it at a glance. It's a lot more nitty-gritty with the details than, for instance, I find Arena is. Arena is, like I said, you can just ascend them all the way to 5, and then you can just make good team compositions. In clan battle, it's more of some characters are actually stronger at less stars and with less gear. It's kind of like a balancing thing in the game, which some people find really enjoyable, other people find frustrating. I personally find it a lot of fun. I really like joining a clan, meeting people, you know, doing your research, trying to do all kinds of, like, you can do trial runs as many times as you want, so you can test different team compositions and see how much damage you can do, and it's a lot of fun. But like I said, it's a monthly thing. You join a clan, It's great. It really is. I highly recommend joining a clan early on when you start the game. All right, so that pretty much covers the three main parts of the game. Let's quickly take a look into some of the other things the game has to offer. So the grotto right here is very straightforward. You'll come here, you'll start off at like quest level 1. You get 2 attempts a day. Think of this like a daily. That's all it is. You come in here every morning or whatever when you first open up the game. You do your 2 attempts in both XP and mana, and then that's it. You won't come back in here until the next day. It's literally just a daily. The dungeon's a little different. It's more of a climb, so to speak. So you'll actually be up against other characters. So think of it kind of like Arena, where you'll actually be up against some of the other characters you can get. But by no means are they like properly well thought out teams, right? They're just 5 random characters, like a tank and some DPS and a whatever. You climb your way as high as you can. There's a boss at the top, usually pretty difficult depending on where you are. And that's pretty much it. You get 1 attempt a day, so you'll go into your, let's say, you'll go into the normal, you'll progress as far as you can, you'll do as much damage as you can against a boss, and then that's it. And then if you didn't manage to clear it by the end of the day, next day you reset it and you reclimb it. That's it. It's another daily kind of thing. Pretty straightforward. So another thing we can look into is the shop right here. You've got all these different tabs at the top. The normal is just on kind of like a normal reset. It's always going to be experience potions and refinement crystals. Don't worry about spending anything in here. At least not until I would say about 70, 80. Once you start hitting around those levels, for whatever reason, both myself and a bunch of friends of mine, whenever we hit about 70, 80, we all ran out of experience potions. So if you want to prepare for that, when you start hitting around maybe level 70 or something like that, start stocking up on these things. Other than that, you don't really touch this unless you really need to. It's pretty straightforward. The bonus shop, which is actually grayed out for me right now, pops up just kind of every now and then when you're doing stuff. You can go in here. It's a big discount on a bunch of different items. Definitely worth purchasing from every time it does pop up. Other than that, that's pretty self-explanatory. Now you've got right here, you've got the dungeon, you've got both the PvP, and then you've got the clan. You get coins for each one respectively. So the higher you climb in the dungeon, the more coins you get. And the coins, you can come in here and you can either purchase memory shards, which are character specific, and it gets updated every now and then. But for the most part, these are just in the shop and it's the only way you can get them. Or you can get gear. First things first, never buy the gear. Unless you're in this situation where you have literally bought every character here all the way up to 5 stars, you won't touch the gear. It's not until later. So we're not even gonna, and it's same rule applies for everything. Don't touch the gear. You'll come in here and you'll get, I don't know, X amount of dungeon coins. You'll say, okay, well, I've managed to pull Nozomi from the gacha system and I would like to get her to 4 stars, so I'm going to focus on her. Simple as that. Same thing goes for Arena, Princess Arena. The higher you climb in the arena brackets, the more coins you earn per hour. So, and don't forget, when you want to claim them, that's not something you just automatically get like the dungeon. You have to actually come in here and receive them. As you can see right now, I have 389 I could pick up. You have to come in here and actually pick them up to spend them. But that's pretty much it. And the same thing works for the clan. When you get your clan rewards after, you know, the monthly clan battle has concluded, you'll come in here and you'll choose which character you want to focus on, and then you'll spend your coins respectively. That kind of clears up the shop. There is actually one more tab called the Divine Amulets. Now think of this as a little bit more of a free-for-all. The Divine Amulet right here, you can get any character, but you only get these Divine Amulets from the gacha system, and it's only when you pull a duplicate. So if you're pulling a bunch of 1 stars and 2 stars and all that stuff, I think 1 stars, it's just kind of like you get 1 Divine Amulet. A 2-star, I believe you get 10. And then if you pull a duplicate 3-star, you get 50. Now, there's a rule of thumb that I think, or at least what I go by personally, is if the character can be farmed by any other means in the game, meaning they're in the shop, or you can farm them in the hard mode, section or whatever means there is, you don't spend divine amulets. And a way to check that is, for instance, if we take a look here in the character screen, let's go ahead and look at someone right here. So let's take a look at Summer Pekarin. As you can see, I only have her at 4-star. I click on the Ascension tab right here, which is where you would go to see how many memory shards I have. I currently have 0 out of 150. If I click on How to Attain, the only means I have of getting memory shards for Summer Pekarin is the Divine Amulet shop, which means I can only spend Divine Amulets to get her. So she's a character I would spend Divine Amulets on. Another example on someone you wouldn't spend Divine Amulets on is, let's go ahead and take a look. Let's say I really wanted to get Rey to 5 stars. I'm like, okay, I'm a third of the way there. I really want to get her to 5. Come here, how to obtain. As you can see, yes, I can go to the Divine Amulet shop, or I can farm her. If there is another means to farm this character, do not spend Divine Amulets on them. Save the Divine Amulets for people you cannot farm. That's generally the rule of thumb I kind of go by, simply because if you ever get to a situation where you're like, okay, hey, I managed to get a bunch of characters who I can farm up to where I want them, and then a new character comes out, especially like some of these summer event characters or the special event characters, you have no means of starring them because you spent all your Divine Amulets on people you can farm for, right? That just makes sense to me, but, you know, take that with a grain of salt. Do whatever you want at the end of the day, but that's my recommendation there. What else? Well, let's take a look at the clan tab real quick. So this is just your general clan. So you join a clan, you're with, I don't know, I don't think it says right here how many members we have, but there are a couple benefits. Obviously, you can participate in clan battle. Another thing is, I think I've actually used, yeah, you can donate right here. This is actually other clan members who are asking, hey, look, I need these items. You can go in here and you can donate to them, and you can give them a maximum of 2. So it's kind of just like a sharing system between all clan members. You can just, they can donate to you, you can donate to them. Just a nice little feature right here. One thing, and this you can go into and you can kind of just mess about and find things out for yourself. It's very straightforward. There's one thing I want to mention that so many people forget that I'm always reminding them. It's right here in support settings. Now, if you're in a clan, as you can see right here, I've got 2 characters in the dungeon and 2 characters in the clan battle, is you can put up your characters in here, which means anybody in the clan can borrow those characters. And every time they do borrow one of your characters, you gain mana. This is really important because, say for instance, if I just have some characters kind of sat in here right now, they're just accumulating mana for me. They're not, I can still use them. I haven't given them away. They literally just sit here, just gaining mana. So clan battle, you can only put people in here when there's actually a clan battle going on, which there is. Otherwise, you just have them sitting here. Even if they don't get used, they still gain mana. So you should always have someone in here. And for instance, just for the sake of the video, Suzuna's managed to pull in, what's that, 100 and almost 150,000 mana. I can end the support right here, gain all the mana, and just put her straight back in. Let's see if I can find. There you go. Simple as that. I just got 150,000 mana just from sitting there. So if you ever find yourself short of mana, don't forget to come back to this page and see if there's anything that you've accumulated over time. Pick it up, put them back in, fire and forget. A lot of people forget about that. Another thing, and I think the final thing we'll end up on is, we'll take a look at the Guildhouse and the story tabs right here. Now there are 2 things in the Guildhouse worth mentioning. I mean, at a glance, it's just you come in here, you can buy some furniture. There's all kind of event furniture. You put it in, you make a little house for your characters. That answers itself. Right here, as you can see, I have like these goofy little things right here. These just provide resource over time. And there's 2 things to mention about them is right here, I can just claim everything, right? So I just got some stamina, got some experience potions, yada yada. You start off with some of these basic ones, which is like, you know, the desk and then these little creation device, mana creation device. These ones that you all start off with, you can level up. And I don't recall exactly what the max level is, but come back, say, every 10 levels or so and level them up, because then you'll just get more free resources over time, right? These ones specifically here are actually from defeating the last boss in the dungeons. So when you defeat a last boss in the dungeon, You'll get this item. It'll show up in your little storage box right here. Don't forget, once you've done the dungeon, come in here, drop it in. More free resources. That's that. The other thing that is incredibly important in my mind is the bond level of your characters. Now, this is something you'll do passively with the characters you're using in story mode. Every time you complete a level, they'll get a bit of bond. You can come in here, you can place them in here, right here with place character. You can see I've got it sorted by bond levels right now. And you can see all of the characters who are 3 stars or more, their max bond level is 8. If they are 2 stars or below, their max bond level is 4. This is important because you can put them in here, and especially if they're characters that you are actively using, and you can give them gifts and you can boost their bond level even faster. Now, this is important because of the story section right here. So every time they gain a bond level, you open up a little story thing that you can watch. Where, let's just have a quick look for the characters specifically. They don't, every time you get a story in here, whether it's character specific or it's guild or it's main or whatever it is, you'll always get some kind of reward just from watching it. So here's an example. Let's take a look at Pekarin right here. Every level we got, and I don't remember exactly, I don't think it shows the jewels, but you get about maybe anywhere between 20 to 50 jewels just from watching the video. But characters, for their bond levels specifically, also get increased stats. So we can take a look right up here to see what they got. So let's take a look at Pekarin's first one. You'll click on this. I'm pretty sure it's like you get 20 jewels and she gains permanent 150 HP, right? Just from increasing her bond level. Increase it again, she gains another 150 HP and 20 jewels. You get the drift, right? This is actually adds up to be quite a bit. You get to 4, there you go. Now it's 300, and I'm pretty sure this was like 50 jewels. So I cannot stress enough, when you've got your characters and they're not at the highest bond level you can get them, drop them in your guild house, give them the candy or gifts or whatever they are to get them to those bond levels, and always clear out the story. If you ever see this kind of like red diamond looking thing sitting here in the story mode, clear it out. You don't have to watch it, honestly. You can click on one and right here in the top right, just click voice off, skip the video, boom, there you go, instant rewards. So can't stress enough, always clear out your stories. You'll get a bunch of jewels, and you'll also get permanent stats for your characters. So with that, I think that pretty much covers everything. Hopefully that gives you a good idea of what the game has to offer. Hopefully you'll get an idea of what it is you want to do, whether you want to join a clan and you want to be competitive. Maybe you just want to get a bunch of characters ready for the arena so you can try and get that number one spot and get a ton of jewels and try and maintain the number one spot. Hopefully that provided you with enough information of what the game has. If you enjoyed the video, go ahead and give it a like. Leave a comment if there's anything you saw that maybe I skipped out on, or if there's you have any questions after the video, and I'll definitely take a look into them. The next part of this, I want to call it a series, but the one thing I obviously didn't touch on is the actual characters. Now I'm going to do another video on this where I'm going to do a deep dive into every character. I'm going to be starting off with any character that comes as a base level 1, and then 2, and then 3, and so on and so forth. We're going to take a look into things like, is the character good? Where are they good? Why are they good? Do they pair well with other characters? Are they good now, but then they'll kind of die off? Or are they kind of not very good now, but they'll become very good in the future with future updates and whatnot? We're going to basically do a huge deep dive into every character, so hopefully by the end of those videos as well, you'll have a good idea of not only what you want to do in the game, but exactly what characters you want to focus on so that you can use your resources wisely. So keep an eye out for that video. I'm working on it at the moment. Otherwise, yeah, hope you enjoyed the video. Like I said, leave any comments if there's anything you missed, and I will see you guys in the next one.